when Sapa comes in, I'm gonna be like, how they smash. He got pounded by Felipe.
Damn.
Gonna? Better than yours at ADCC, because you never made it. You got submitted by a Star Wars nerd. And I've also never been submitted in comp, so you can suck me from the back.
That's fine, he just lost 8 now.
Well, you would have got submitted by Felipe Pena. Easily.
Oh yeah.
You would have got absolutely mauled.
Us natural athletes have trouble against cheaters.
Yeah, just throw a heel hook at him. That would have worked.
This is the problem. Finally get somebody who's over 100 kilos and he's falling apart. Probably going to be tape break. Of several.
Well, there'll be one of those or a wee break or a poo break.
Why do you do this? My toes is all spiked. I've got brittle skin.
Does your skin get thinner when you get diabetes?
Yeah, easily bruised. Then.
Does it?
No. I don't actually have diabetes. No, seriously, what? There's a lot of tension on the temple.
He's such a simp, I don't even do the right thing. And he goes, yeah, it was working.
Alright. Oh, well, I'll just go to sleep then, I won't say anything.
Well, be a man about it.
Hey, Dave, why don't you fucking talk later?
You can finish me if you wanted to.
Can finish us off, sir.
What did he say?
Couldn't finish us off, sir.
So you might find that just one or two pendulums and a pull of the elbow works, and then you'll find from here he's going to go in the back and head and arm, and then we're going to defend that, but we're out of a deep cutting coming. Other options is I use a pendulum, and then from here I start kipping. He's allowing me to just pull this down. Okay, the kipping will only work if he's still tight.
Yes. That can come out the back door, right? If you feel like you go to kip and then your elbow just comes down to your hip, there's no strangle anymore. If he's still sustaining the strangle, that backwards roll is going to come into play. Let's give it a go.
I would give you this anyway.
You do.
Look straight at the camera, there's a little there. Just before you hit the keg of helmet.
Yeah. Who are you from there?
Bro.
Begin when you're ready.
What? She's popping your toes.
It's all cracking.
Ugh.
Thank you.
Had to move the rig.
The cunt behind me fucking parks in the spot, and I need to reverse to get out from the car in front of me. Just wouldn't move.
Don't turn me that camera.
Gym etiquette. We don't do like the fake respect, os, clap your fucking legs, gay shit, clap everybody's hands at the end of class. We do cleanliness respect. Make sure that the Chesterton lounges aren't staffed. Maybe we'll do more videos if people enjoy that. Maybe. If you comment down below and you want to see more videos of what we're doing, which this week kind of happens to be not a lot. Actually, there's a competitive fitness expo coming up, which will be fun. We had to bash some people in front of some normies. That would be good. I think that could be quite fun. I'm going to join that, sign up to that. I think it's the 29th of April, which is also my brother and sister's birthday, but I'm going to go compete instead. And then what else? Let's go to the board. Oh, so that is the fitness expo one. Subversion's in June. May, tough rolls. Luke has a seminar. If you want to go to a seminar and you live in Queensland on the 14th of May, I would recommend doing that. Grappling Industries in June, and oh, that's the Grappling Federation one in Canberra in June as well. June's gonna be busy. June's gonna be busy. I was gonna verse Moody on M16, but that clashes with Subversion, unfortunately. So that's gonna be the end of the year. Adam Jones and Miles are doing a really good job with that, so it'll be awesome to be on their show. They're finally moving out of the basketball court that they've been doing with the fucking kids' iPad for streaming. Like, production value, shit, but good blokes, times 10. So it kind of like equates it out a little bit. Whereas Subversion has one half amazing people, Maddie, and one half dog shit people, George. And then the production value is amazing, but that's also Matt's fault, not George's fault. So basically, fuck George Hanlon. We're getting some pirating of the footage with the autist. Put him on camera, he loves attention. He absolutely loves social attention. That's what happens when he waits for the bus. And it's late. This is what Axel does when he waits for the bus and it's late. The bus goes past him.
That's what I'm saying. That training was like
really we're doing Q&A one day. He's laying down on the mats, flat. He meant to be paying attention to the Q&A. And I just see him grab both sides of his head and do this for like a minute. I'm like, oh,
yes, not true.
This is... See, this is what we have to deal with on a day-to-day basis. So not only are we trying to like make people good at jiu-jitsu, we have to like curtail the personalities of all the autists. Might help you. Like when I was his age, I got a part-time job and I was like, all right, I'm gonna force myself to speak to adults. Oof. And that worked great.
Rough, hey?
Not really, I liked it. I liked it because I was talking about like supplements and protein and all the stuff that I was interested in. And they wanted to ask me how to lift weights, which is great. So anyway, that's a bit of a backstory. We'll see you in the next episode. There will be more episodes coming in the future. We're not gonna tell you when. We're not gonna tell you what they're gonna be about. They're not gonna be customized to what you wanna see. It's just gonna be what we wanna produce. And if you like it, you like it. If you don't like it, fuck off.
Bye.
Bye.